hell of a lot of time on Sniper as well. I think we're in terms of the next game, we're going to be watching the team we just saw win. So TCM, Flushy and Captain and Happy Cool and Settler and everyone else's team. I've got to say everyone else now because otherwise it will sound bad. Kafka and Sheepy as well as team. They're going to be playing off against, I think, Coast to Coast.
I think it's Coast to Coast. I was looking there earlier, and it should be an interesting game. I think they're fairly evenly matched, these teams.
Yeah, so who do Coast to Coast have playing? I think, did they play with Talash as a merc, actually?
Yeah, Talash was playing for them earlier, and he was definitely playing really well. Talash has had experience at top prem level, albeit not in officials, but he's definitely played at the top level as scout, and so obviously he finds this skill level is a bit not easy, but not as challenging as he's used to. So he
Yeah.
does really well.
I'm looking at the ETF to a match of their game before, and I think they equally won 5-0. So on that team that we might be looking at later, they're going to have Ramagan on Medic. I casted them 2 days ago, actually. So it's going to be Ramagan, Medic, Kuno on Demo, Lippy and AMS Soldier, I think, and Empty and Talash on Scout. What do you think of that?
Yeah, it's the same roster as yesterday, wasn't
I
it?
imagine so.
I think so, yeah. Well, yeah, Talash was carrying them pretty hard from what I saw. I think he was second on the damage, at least in the game I saw. So that's pretty amazing performance for a scout. Although his scout partner, Empty, I'm not really sure how good he is. I've only really seen him on the soldier role. He
Yeah, me
plays
too.
he's played Roma for God knows how many years. He's the MGE king, so I've not seen him on that many teams.
He beat you, though? It's the big question. Did
What was that,
he
sorry?
beat you on MGE?
Oh, he's never beat me on MGE.
All right, and on that note, kid, no, I'm joking. So I'm not sure when that's going to go live. I think it was scheduled for Q2, which we're just coming up to now. And if they have finished, then hopefully we'll be able to get that game going fairly quickly. I'm not sure what we're doing in terms of break between matches, but if we're just hitting the time now, then it seems reasonable that we might just continue.
Okay. Well,
I think we're waiting for server info as well, so
yeah, okay. I hate to leave you on your own here, Ali, but I'm just going to quickly get a glass of water. I'll be 20 seconds.
cool. Can deal with that. Yeah, I'm gonna get the team rosters and post them in Twitch chat so people can have a look over who we will be having to play. In the chat, no, that's the straw poll. Basically, go to ETFTwo and search for Coast to Coast because that's going to be the team that they're just going to be playing off against. If you look at the brackets for the cup, then you're going to see the quarterfinal match that they played is going to be filled in, of course. Their normal roster, Puss, Tash as a merc. I'm not exactly sure who their normal scout is to fill that role. Talash has definitely been playing for the last few days, but I remember him saying he played for them, I think, 2 days ago, and they asked him to merc for the rest of the tournament. People in chat calling out Talash for being maybe not necessarily a top prem scout, as Stark said, but I think relative to this map, I think relative.
I never said he was a top prem scout. I said he's got experience at the top level of prem.
Okay. But I think he's definitely one of the double mix group who will have played this map forever. So, in terms of ability relative to this map, I think in terms of scouts, he will be at the top level.
Yeah, he'll be the higher end of scouts outside of maincall.tf in the tournament. So it's kind of on. Wait, who are the Coast to Coast scouts? Because I heard the Ethog was trialing for them, but
Talash and
yeah.
Empty.
Yeah, so it's right, okay, so Sheepy and Happy Cool have got their work cut out for them. Although I reckon Sheepy could challenge Talash. I'm not really sure how Sheepy's been playing recently, but he seemed to be playing pretty solidly that map.
Yeah, sure. I mean, he's definitely got the raw ability. I've yet to see. Well, I haven't seen much of Happy Core. That's not to take any away from him. It's just to say that I haven't seen him play against this top level of scout kind of thing. There I go again, complimenting Talash. Ridicule me all you want. But yeah. So server,
So
server, server. Okay, I think
it's
we do have a server.
AMS on Pocket and Lippy on Roam, is it?
I imagine so. I remember Lippy played for 425 at the end of last season, was it? I can't remember who his soldier partner was then, but I'm pretty sure he was on Roma.
Yeah, they always seem to be off-nicking, those two soldiers, so I never really knew who was who.
Kuna was beasting when I saw him 2 days ago, just running, jumping in with pipes, and it was a bit over-aggressive, but the point was he had the DM to back it up, so...
He's kind of like a fledgling Exxon.
Fledgling Exxon.
Yeah, I remember when he first kind of got noticed by the big boys. They all laughed at him because he pretty much does the exact same thing Kuna does now. He still does it to a certain degree, but he's definitely matured as a player. I reckon Kuna will do the same thing.
Sure. All right. So either way, we're going to look at these two teams. Obviously, we've seen, well, both of them have played well on Longjam enough up to this point that we can just compare. I think we can more so compare players in the sense that both these teams aren't going to be making any big mistakes on the map. So, in terms of individual classes, looking at Medic first, you're looking at Ramagan up against Flushy. Flushy, of course, the old guard of TF2. And Ramagan, more recently arriving to the top level. I think he played for, did he play for TC at I-52? Who was seeded just outside the top eight group, but I think they beat AoGirl in the last stages of the competition, didn't they? So
AoGirl, the top eight team.
There was debatably that in the first place, but I think they finished top eight at LAN. They finished top eight with him on Medic, so he does have a good amount of experience, but not much Nick the Flushy. Moving on, you've got Settler versus Kuna. As an ex-demo man, what do you think of that?
I reckon Kuna's going to take it. Even though before I've said that Kuna has dodgy mid fights at best, where he seems to sticky himself in and shoot pipes, I think he's kind of getting out of that habit and going a bit more aggressive, which you kind of need to do on this map.
I've seen Sadler with some pretty impressive pipe aim actually, but I think he can't play too aggressive against Kuna, because when it comes down to a DM fight, I think Kuna would take it.
Yeah, I'd put my money on Kuna as well. But I reckon Kuna's going to out-damage him.
Sure. In terms of soldiers, Lippy, we talked a bit about AMS too. Do you know much about AMS?
He's kind of, I put him in the same kind of boat as Captain, the kind of upcoming soldiers, not quite Prem, but soon to be type of skill level.
Sure. We're going to see how those two face up against each other on Pocket then.
Yeah, that'll be interesting. It should be a fairly even match, I assume.
And then Kafka and Lippy against each other in a room. Kafka, I think, put in a bit of a solid shift last map. Didn't see any crazy DMs. Pardon?
Is that Samsa?
He played as Kafka, probably Samsa, yeah. I don't remember seeing Samsa's name, so yeah, that would be right.
I'm not sure. I think Samsa's going to take that. I don't really remember playing. When we played against Lippy, I didn't really notice him that much. I'm not sure that is how the team is structured or it's because of him as a player, but I reckon Samsa is the upcoming talent. He's going to take it in terms of their kind of 1v1 matching in the game.
Sure. And scouts we've already discussed, so we're going to have to see how that plays out individually. I think they're still saying that they're trying to connect to... still trying to connect the relay to the server. Some people still on the SDV of the map they're trying to connect to, so that they can't. So there's one slot in spec which they're trying to put the, or there's one slot in the, which they're trying to put the SDV into, but someone's taken it pretty much.
How dare they?
How dare they indeed? Anyone, we'll find the IP and then shoot it out into the chat so someone can DDoS them.
That's a good idea.
That is a good idea. It reminds me of when you did DDoS to me. Do you remember that?
I don't remember what you're talking about. DDoSing is illegal and I would never do that. So, on to... Actually, I'm not sure. What haven't we talked about?
All right, well, just as an update, David says they're 9-on. So, talking about the other semi-final that's going to be going on, I presume it's going to be Furbo Pandas versus Mankel, presuming those guys won their respective matches. I'll look on ETF2L now, but what do you think about that game if it comes down to it?
It should be easy for Mainpool. I don't see any way they're going to lose that. I mean, they've got every single advantage. I mean, they've got the DM, got the bigger ips with the main calls. He's got so much experience.
Phobopanda's lost.
Phobopanda's lost versus who?
Boys in spandex.
I thought they got a default win versus those guys.
Well, I'm looking at the brackets now, and it says that the Swedish team Boys in Spandex took the points against Phobopanda's.
Who's Boys in Spandex?
I'll read you out the roster. In Medic, they have Nijunen.
Oh, right, yeah.
Demankor, Pocket Colon, Roma Puzzle, Scout. Is that Swichen or whatever his name is? I can't remember.
All right, yeah.
And then I'm not even going to try and pronounce it.
Go on then.
Doesn't roll off the English tongue.
Go on, say it.
Schoberg.
How do you spell that?
S Joe Berg.
Schoberg. I don't know.
We need to listen in here.
Players apart from Swichen. So
Schoberg apparently is according to David. All right. Who was in a team with him? That's a fairly good source of information.
You never know. He could have been lying.
Okay, I think David and Ari might have almost sorted it out now. They're restarting the SDV so we can get our relay. I'm not going to read out the log that they've just sent me because it's a bit insulting towards one of the players. But basically, they're restarting the server because someone had ping.
Fair enough. So hopefully it won't be too much longer. Oh, it's a default loss for Phobopandas. So Boys in Spandex didn't actually beat them. So
all right.
It should be even easier for Minkle because I don't recognize these people.
Well, Minkle might underestimate them.
Ips doesn't underestimate anyone. He's the keenest bean that has ever played TF2.
I'll take your word in that respect. But yeah, so assuming we'll see a Minkle final, which of these teams now do you think would be the best? Could give them the best game, if not could challenge them for the title?
I reckon it's going to be Coast to Coast.
Which ties in with the question of who do you think will win?
Minkle. Not very controversial, but...
I meant who ties in with the question of who do you think will win this map to go on to face Minkle, that is.
Ah, right, yeah. I reckon Coast to Coast is going to win it. Although I don't think it's going to be a roll. I think it's going to be pretty close. I'm going to say 5-3. Lay down the gauntlet to Coast to Coast.
Well, compared to the fairly slow-moving match last time, we can but hope in that respect.
Go on then. What's your prediction?
I think I'd probably have to go with the same result, really. But I'm gonna go for something more like. Wait, what did you say?
5-3.
That sounds quite respectable, actually. I'll go 6-2.
6-2.
Yeah. They're just not gonna be able to get the final round. Yeah, I do have the stats up, so hopefully the SDV will be to follow.
We can only hope. Yeah, I think it's Happy Cool's having ping problems.
According to Flushy, they're still disagreeing about servers, and they are really sorry about the delay. So, anyone in chat, direct your feelings towards Flushy. I'm joking. Don't do that.
Direct your hate towards Iceland in general, especially their internet services.
All right. They're switching again. Oh, wow.
Yeah. I'm watching it from Kuna's perspective. They don't seem very... I seem a bit nonplussed. I think they're playing the old version of Logjam.
Yeah,
also
so
annoying.
On the past map, I think we saw with B9, has there been I think there was a more recent version really released. I think it must have been the past couple of days, was it?
I think it was last night, where he, Heist being the excellent map of the years, he took in all the feedback and decided to completely redo the mid overnight, pretty much.
Sure.
And he made it very, very similar to Badlands, which people might give him a slack for, but
I mean, it's a winning formula given how popular it is. So
definitely a winning formula, and it doesn't feel like you're playing Badlands. It's just copying the bridge idea, which is kind of the easy way to get a successful mid. But it seems to be improved. But I guess the teams had, if they both agreed, they could play the new version of the map. But I guess they haven't had a chance to play test it, so they want to play the old map because they know what they're doing on it.
Sure. I've been taking a second to give credit to Heist in terms of how prompt he is with doing all things. I can remember when we were playing double mixes and it was a case of every night we'd play it and then just sort of have suggestions. And then the next night he'd come back with all the changes and the download ready kind of thing.
Yeah.
I mean, he was really like strong on like taking on feedback and bringing it forward.
If only we had more people like Heist, then we wouldn't have Granary.
Yeah, how many more maps do you think? Well, we need one more map, I think, and then we could kick Granary out of the map pool, and then another map, and we could get rid of Snake Water, and then everyone would be happy.
Snake Water.
Pardon?
I mean, I think this is another unpronounceable name. I think it's like Showy or something, but the guy who made
Snake Water, I know
he was making kind of he was making little hints that he might work on Snake Water.
Sure. Okay.
Which I definitely appreciate because it's got some issues.
If I can remember, there was a point where he got rid of certain things, such as I think it was drop down to appease. I think it was to appease Valve, such that it could be accepted as an official map. Correct me if I'm wrong.
Yeah. And also, he got rid of loads of fences as well. But it was a good change. The recent update to Snake Water. I say recent. It was quite a few months ago now. It just needs a little bit more, and then I'd accept it as a good map.
Sure. Still waiting around for that SDV. We have the stats. We don't have the SDV, though.
We can radiocast it.
We could radiocast it. Have you been watching Sideshow's recast of his I-52 footage?
Yeah, there's some excellent stuff in there. Some of it
the
not
radio
so casts, safe for work.
The radio, yeah, not safe for work. The radiocast, though, to the extent when he leaves his lens cap on.
All right, yeah.
Incredible coverage.
I remember on one day, the day I met him, I met him on a later date because he was supposed to pick me up, but his car broke down. He'd been walking around for the whole day. It was about 3 o'clock, and I just said, "Sideshow, your lens cap's on." And what he said, I can't repeat now, but basically he'd recorded about 5 hours of footage, all with the lens cap on.
Yeah. Classic. Good idea, though, taking a GoPro around LAN. He caught a lot of good moments. I'm never going to plug Sideshow's YouTube channel in my life, but I'll give him that it was funny. So we do have, I think the server's going to be really, really soon. Thanks everyone for sticking around. If you have done, or even if you just arrived, we're going to be watching the semi-final of the Logjam Cup, which has been running for nights and nights. So if you're not sick, or even if you are sick, then there's only one more night left. So besides the whole season, but yeah.
Okay. Praise the Lord. Happy Cool has decent ping. I think it means we might be starting.
Excellent. The server has the old whitelist, though, so...
Just go.
Apparently she... Oh, no. Apparently Sheepy's saying it's too high for him.
Oh, God.
And Ari's saying, oh, please, no. I think they must have to come to some kind of compromise, though, given it's two players from TCM. Who are suffering. They've got to find some middle ground, given no one from coast to coast, I think, is having issues.
I mean, his ping's not unplayable, especially for a scout. I mean, it's pretty common for American scouts to come play on EU with, like, 120 ping. So this, like, yeah, sub 100 ping is definitely feasible.
There's one connect shot out into our Slack channel, but I think that's in terms of... That might be the new server, the new server. Several iterations on. Oh, okay, so they're not changing it again, according to Flashy. That was the last change. Still fine. give a shout out to Studio's straw poll in chat. So you disagree with Stark. Although it appears, Stark, your influence is worn, actually not worn through, because people think Team Coolamandy is going to take this map, spurred on by their commanding performance in the previous game.
Do we know who Coast to Coast just played?
Coast to Coast just played... I saw the match page a second ago. Danger Dogs.
Danger Dogs. They're Div 2, aren't they? Div 2 slash 3? Something like that.
I'm looking on their team page now. Season 18, they played Div 2A. It looks like they might have got fairly thumped, but so yeah, definitely Div 2. definitely Div 2. Maybe not so quite Div 1 yet, but possibly there by the end of this tournament.
Just want to point out that I've been watching Kuna's stream and he's got pretty good air shots on the set like twice in a row now, so it looks like
we
my
do have a connect,
working
though.
Out well. Oh, really?
Hallelujah.
Excellent.
I'll send it to you.
Let's pray for a fast start.
Well, David was asking if we were ready yet, so I think it's the case of as soon as we get this, they're ready to go. I mean, they definitely won't be waiting for people. Oops.
Hopefully not. I've got the inside info watching. It's pretty nice that everyone streams their pub nowadays. You can kind of tell what's going on. Oh, they've readied up on Kuna's stream,
sure.
So
okay,
it should be
so
around about a minute.
That sounds good. So I'm back in the server too. And finally, we get to give some sort of countdown without knowing, as opposed to not knowing when the game was going to start. Aspects you think TCM can improve on from last map?
I think their mid fights, they had it easy on their mid fights versus... or what is it now? HKN, that's the one. Since they were so passive, and I have a feeling that Coast to Coast is going to be a bit more aggressive, although I'm not sure, but I reckon Talish is going to be trying to smash the flank. So if Kuna can go off Talish's space that he makes, I think TSM's definitely going to have a hard time.
Sure, sounds good. I definitely agree with that. We must be very close now to starting, so thank you for everyone who's stuck around and not want to watch Sideso's stream of a black screen because he hasn't put his lens cap on. The good luck, have fun, are coming out in chat. I'm stuck in spawn now, and they are finally here. So welcome everyone, and thank you for sticking around for the semi-final of the EPFL Logjam Cup, now going on between TCM and Coast to Coast, the winner going through to the final to face either Poison Spandex or maincool.tf. Coming on to this first middle, Stark, what are you seeing?
I'm seeing crits from Coast to Coast in the hands of Ramagan. So I'm going to, since it's so long for me, he's already at 50%, so I'm pretty interested to see what they're going to do. But Kuna goes down immediately to Settler. So Coast to Coast should back out here and re-push for the crits. But it looks like they want to fight this, actually. And AMS going huge, getting two frags, and Talash following him up and getting third. And Ramagan almost got the crits ready. So if TCM aren't backing out here, it's going to be dangerous for him.
Yeah, he's going to get flanked, though, I think. Where is he? Ramagan. Oh, they've won the fight against Talash. Talash managed to take Settler down, which is a really good trade for him. But Ramagan was just... he was disconnected for so long there that he's only just hitting that crit streak now, and they've already lost the middle cap. There was a point there where it looked like there was time to back out because when they lost their demo man, but it was a big play by AMS, but... the rest of his team just scattered and he was left alone Ramagan, so they didn't have their crits. If he had crits for Talash there, I think Talash could have cleaned up at the end of that middle. But they're still out of it now, and they've still got Flushy with about 25 seconds window. And it looks like they're coming in from a cave.
I think
I'm watching the demo
they're
man now.
So passive. I think they must have seen the crits. And Flushy's just backing out Chokies.
They're
going to
get
trying to bait out the crits.
Oh, and soldiers onto the medic.
Saxa bombs in. And oh, Ramagan pops.
He pops. Oh,
I'm scared of that drop log.
That was a bit of a poor pop there. I think Kafka or Samsa should have finished him off there. But he did his job as a roamer. He got the pop, which is all that's really needed. Now we're going to see the Uber come back out. quite early from the area they were pushing, but they managed to catch up Puna as well as AMF. That was a really nice job. They lose Happy Cool on the flank, but that is a really good trade for them ultimately, as Ramagan is still quite a way off his crits, and without a demo man to use it on, it's definitely a lot harder. You can see them actually losing second here due to still being three players having not spawned yet. So crits pushing out from last, do you think?
Yeah, I mean, they've got quite a sizable advantage. Flushy's not been building at all. He should be like 60% right now, but he's only on 36. So TTM are going to play this so passively, and if Coast to Coast play this quickly, they can get the point before having crits. But they use the crits and they pick off Settler, which isn't too bad, but it doesn't look like they're going to get anything else. And TTM back out, and they've got 70% to work with.
Yeah, I mean, Ramagan not having died, TTM would have definitely known the crits was there, and Flushy, with all the experience, you can imagine, was definitely knew where he should be. Maybe not experiencing a lockdown, but experiencing crits, in that you really shouldn't be able to see the other team's demo man when they're hitting crit screen. And now he's going to have Izzy, but coming back through choke, there's a couple of sticky setups, still one crit sticky left on that rock. It looks like they're going to be opting going for the cave route. The scout down there empty should be able to spot him quite soon, and the spam is already coming out there, so they're going to have to pop quite early if they maintain their spam. But there's actually no pressure left, and they're going to push all the way through, but he loses so many players there. Settler goes down to her sticky trap, and the pop is going to be able to do nothing, and the frags are well and truly in favour of Coast to Coast at the moment, who should be able to take this second point easily.
And the crits is ready, and TTM are kind of scattered around. I'm not sure where Flushy is, but he should be running out, and Kuna really wants this crits. You can see him charging.
The jump from Captain, though. Captain jumps over the team's head. He's onto the medic. Can he hit the final rocket? He surfs another rocket into cave. He catches Ramagan. Really nice play there from Captain. Quite lucky for him in the way he caught that final rocket through after Ramagan, but really good play there from the pocket as well.
Yeah, these. Kuna was like holding on for that crits for ages. He wasn't that
behind.
Perfect sticky. And yeah, and Flushy counting his lucky stars that he can go down there. He kind of evades AMS just by closing his eyes and running around.
I think it was one of those surfs when you're a medic and you catch a rocket from behind, and you don't even jump, but you catch the momentum forward, and you're suddenly sort of air strafing to try and avoid something you don't know about. But yeah, I would never critique Flushy's skill. He probably knew it was there, but probably much to your relief, we're seeing that pyro again as the team try and push him to top left. He goes down much earlier than Happy Cool had before Talash, but they've got the heavy up, so this is going to turn him to quite a hard push actually for TCM. They really need to take that heavy down, but heavy is doing so much work. He finally gets completely crushed by two scouts and the heavy all getting on at the same time. And with just Lippy and Kuna left alive, now, he's above the point. You can still hide up there, but he's got too much of a job to do. I'm not going to be able to achieve anything.
I've not seen that one before. As soon as they knew he was there, it was kind of useless, so...
Yeah.
On this mid, I don't know. The mids, they need to be... in more aggression from Coast to Coast, I think. Or at least, if it starts going well and they pick the enemy medic, they need to back out a bit faster and not lose everyone. Like they did on the previous mid.
Yep, so moving on to the next mid, neither team opting for a fast rollout. It seems you might have to wait till the actual grand final itself to see some of that quick action. And quite a passive mid again, but AMS picking up the frag onto Kafka, winning the battle of the roamers. There's a now counter jump from Lippy trying to get aggressive, but he just jumps into Sheepy and gets completely knifed. Sheepy rushing across the point now, picks up another frag too, gets good pressure into Demo. Demo is down too. Medic down though for Flushy. They're going to win the mid, but Ramagan is left alive. He's got such a hard job now. He's fighting a Demo man and a scout. Scout is really weak though, Sheepy, but Selet will be chasing him. He's still dancing around in this middle. He's definitely... No, he's gonna die, yeah.
MS is playing so well on these mid-fights and is still not working out for them. I don't really know what to suggest. I mean, he comes in from behind and gets big frags, but then I assume it's happening to Coast at the same time. They're getting flanked.
It was really bad for Ramagan there. I mean, there was no reality he was gonna get out there, and he's cost his team a massive disadvantage. Flushy gonna have, what, now 25 seconds advantage, where he might have only had sort of 10 or 15 before, to the extent that he could sort of duke it out at the end of a fight and be able to just Uber in time, but
Ramagan's going for crits again. He's gonna have the crits disadvantage, the idea being that TCM use their Uber just normally to get into the point, and then the second they start capping the point and the Uber fades, they can re-crits on them. And they've also got Talash on Sniper watching this log room area from just outside forward spawn.
Yeah, it looks like Flush is going to come from that lower area. Last time it didn't work out for them, and they forced really early this time to try and counter it. Really nice dump from Captain. He's going to pick up the frag onto AMS. He's so close to that crit screen, but he's completely alone, Ramagan. His demo just runs away from him, and he has no choice but to just run into Settler's pipes. And now with two down and no one down to TCM, they should just be able to push onto this last point fairly easily. Their heals aren't the best currently, and they're just trying to... They're running into a hell of a lot of spam, but they managed to take down Empty, and the scouts and soldiers getting really well forward, and finally the rest of TCM come in, and this should just be a straight cleanup.
Yeah, that was fairly poorly played by Kuna there. He played as if he still had a pocket with him to protect his medic, but it was only him, and he walked forwards, and the demos just walked past each other and set that killed his med. So yeah. He could have, if they played that a bit more passively, they could have actually won that. As I watched Settler do something very strange on his rollout, he's going to be very slow.
Yeah, Kuda definitely making use of that and getting right away across the point. He stickied out that middle access to the midfield from the Sorum. His team, TCM, are just going to have to be right their way back. Kuna only just now reaching middle, shooting the stickies up. The jump comes in from the soldier, but it's just a distraction across the point. I think I've seen this move before, actually. Clearly something they've worked on as a coordination, the soldiers. And the scouts now from coast to coast are just pressuring the team back, but the rest of TCM just walk across point and clean up the whole combo. And it's just the scouts left alive now from coast to coast. They did such a good job in forcing back TCM, but they only caught a couple of players, and the rest of TCM just walked across point as Empty, the last player alive, gets killed, and briefly that was a whole wipe.
Kuna was in the perfect position to destroy the enemy team, but he just had his pipes out. He had his pipes out, and he started rushing him with his pipes out, and he hit one pipe. And if he had 8 stickies instead of putting up a sticky trap, he would have won the mid on his own.
But definitely gonna have to start eating our own predictions or eating our words relative to, I think, the margins we gave coast to coast in terms of winning this. I mean, my prediction of 6-2 is surely going to be ended fairly soon, as they're going to be pushing into this last with 100% advantage. This time pushing in from that lower left, which we really haven't seen for a while. The STV stats coming out and saying that Flushy had his Uber 40 seconds actually before using it, but they're using it well now. They clean up without losing anybody once again. They're so well at holding his Uber. Kuna once again on top of the point isn't going to be able to achieve any frags and just going to go this straight down. What do you make of that hold on top of the point where he can't help his team for the entire fight?
Yeah, his team needs to not die, basically. It's the only way it's going to work. I mean, he's always been the last one alive before he actually gets focused. His team needs to just trust him with the point, sit really far back, and then only come out when they start shooting at Kuna. And at this mid-fight, again, let's see what Kuna does, because I think he is the deciding factor. If he can do loads of damage, then they're going to win this mid. But again, I don't like what he's doing with his pipes. He can't make any space for his team, but actually his team's making space on their own.
But yeah, really nice work that comes from the point, but TCM are just holding so fast on their errors, and they're just throwing players at them coast to coast and losing. There's one play by Empty there, who managed to win actually a nice 1v1 against Samson before being picked up by Captain. Nice pipe by Kuna now, managing to hold it off, but he's got to back out. Doesn't back out quickly enough, and Sheepy's onto him, and just Ramagan left alive now. He's on 89%, there's no way he's going to win this 1v1. Sheepy's going to take him down, and this is massively in favour of TCM and Flushy once again.
Yeah, exactly what I said. He needs to not immediately change to pipes the second he runs out of stickies. He needs that aggression to push over with 8 stickies loaded, because he's on this mid. It's all about pushing across the point with the demo man. And Talash gets a nice pick on Settler, actually. And this could make this push a little easier on coast to coast, but they lose Lippy as well. And they lose Empty. This is looking pretty dire for coast to coast. If they catch out Ramagan, it's another round to TCM.
Yeah, it definitely looks like, it looked like the scouts wanted to give chase then for a bit TCM, but seems like they're content. If they go really quickly, they're going to be able to catch up Ramagan from his Uber, and Captain is jumping forward really quickly. They've got a scout with him too. They're going to Uber right in. Where is Ramagan? He catches one rocket. He's back in spawn there. They should be all right. They
he's
need to get time on point there if they want to win
crits.
This fight.
It's actually crits.
Oh, that was a big sticky Kuna. Takes down both scouts with a single crit sticky. Not going to clean up anything else though, but the whole team of coast to coast is there. It's just one soldier left in, and Ramagan jukes away. 50 HP survives, and that's a full wipe in favour of coast to coast. That must be the first one this game.
Yeah, that was a risky crit switch, especially after they lost 3 players and couldn't force the Uber as TCM came in. But it paid off, as TCM just taking a bit too long to get the frags on the last push, and the crits obviously came in and destroyed them. And now they've got an advantage of about 80% with the crits advantage included, and they're going to be pushing on to the second.
This must be the first time that, well, one of the first times that coast to coast have actually had a proper advantage, because it seems it's always been TCM pushing with the momentum and coast to coast managing to hold them up for a tiny bit, but ultimately losing the fights. They look like they wanted to go through cave then, but they've actually come around choke. There's a soldier hiding there. Kafka really jumped. He's holding it off a bit, and they're just taking so much spam. Now this jump from Samsa comes in. He gets rockets on, and Ramagai goes down. That was that a drop?
Yeah.
Died with 95%. Nice combined spam rockets there. Unlucky by Ramagan, but he just took a bit too much spam ultimately. As the scouts from coast to coast, they're still on that point, trying to get the cap off, and it looks like they're doing a really nice job of denying. Empty's going a bit too far in, but Talish is going to be there to finish off the point. Now he has to back out though and risk not facing the two scouts from TCM. That could have been a backup opportunity there, but I just don't think they managed to slip anyone past.
Ramagan's still on crits.
Ramagan's still on crits though. He might not get out here though. The scouts are really far forward, and it just looks like Happy Cool and Sheep are just gonna power through, take down three, the core combo in quick succession of coast to coast. And once again, the momentum is back in favor of TZM. They're gonna have a massive uber advantage by the time Ramagan spawns.
I'm not really sure what they were doing on that crits push. I mean, it was just Kuna with Ramagan, and there was no pocket protection. So the soldier bombed in, Kuna couldn't react in time, and Ramagan obviously isn't going to pop the crits for one soldier. I mean, it's not worth it.
Within 10 seconds there, it was the scouts of just the scouts of TCM, that is, just cleaned up five frags. Really nice work, really nice uber actually, a really solid uber, but ultimately a four crits. As we see the aggression come out from coast to coast, trying to get that damage down to Plushy, but Plushy is surviving like a boss. They're only just losing Sheepy now. Kuna comes out to try and do something, but Settler takes him down with his pipes, and this is surely going to be 100%. Ramagan only on 70, and only with Lippy alive to protect him. There's a scout already in, Happy Cool, juking around the damage from Lippy. The uber comes out, this is surely 4-0. Oh, but the drop! It was
another crits, and it was an uber sword. I think he might be stuck on crits, actually. But actually, coast to coast look like they're going to hold this.
Spawns come in.
Wow, that was really surprising. I mean, it looked like it was all over, especially when Ramagan had to go for that Ubersaw and died on the point. But
yeah,
TCM don't look too bad out of this. I mean, they've got an advantage. Yeah, he's still on crits. It could be a loadout issue. It's forcing him to stay on crits because it's obviously not advisable to stay on crits the entire game.
He could have been able to switch, and now he's going to watch the VOD back and feel rubbish.
Yeah.
TCM doing the right thing here and just sitting back waiting for the Uber to build. They know there's probably a risk of crits, so it's very sensible just to chill and make sure they know if it is crits. Finally moving forward now as they're hitting that 95%. Kalash on the sniper now. Gonna see if he manages to be able to do anything. He's on that top right area at the moment. Is he gonna change? But yeah, he's changed back. Probably just for the best. They've got a heavy there, but the heavy needs to survive the onslaught. He's just chilling and spawn for a bit. The crits now comes out, but they're just hitting an uber player so far. They managed to take on Settler. That's a good frag. But the pressure is instantly on Captain. Kuna doing a marvellous job of turning around and putting that single sticky onto Captain to keep his medic alive. I'm not sure how much Ramagan went down to them, but there was definitely a lot of focus going towards him. And once again, we're going to see both teams using their uber, but coming out of it. This time, coast to coast with more players alive and still with that quick advantage. So they're going to be in the driving seat.
Yeah, and it looks like TCM being forced out. Good spam by Kuna. In fact, Blushy went down to 20 HP to Kuna's roller spam there. That would have been an excellent opportunity to push, but it looks like they're going to be moving fast anyway because their window of opportunity is pretty small and their crits haven't been that great so far. Let's see if they actually have a pocket with the crits so Kuna doesn't have to do all the work.
It looks crits like they comes do. Out. Crits doesn't achieve out. Anything. Oh, nice sticky there. Samsa was just about to jump the combo, but Kuna read it really, really well. Only one soldier frag though isn't ideal from the crits. I'm not sure if the medic just went out of view as he saw him, or if he was just hoping that he'd be able to catch someone as he walked around the corner. TCM doing though a nice job of catching out the TCM players who are overextending, and the Uber Force on point is gonna. They haven't killed Ramagan, which is the important thing, but they will be able to get a Demoman frag and hopefully a scout too if they manage to take down Palash. There's two of them there, a soldier and a scout. The rest of the team from coast to coast is coming back in now. It's AMS and Ramagan on the point. Can they put the pressure down onto Ramagan? He needs to do a marvellous job here of protecting him, but they haven't seen that soldier coming in. Really nice rockets from AMS, but it's not going to be enough, and surely Ramagan's going to go down here as well.
Oh!
He gets the frag, but he can't take down the Demoman and the soldier as well.
I'm not really sure what happened, and the fight got so messy, it ended up with Kuna behind them in cave, and he managed to pick up a Demoman before getting taken down himself. I'm not really sure what's going on here. Like, it seems TCM is much more coordinated in these messy fights than coast to coast, and they're definitely taking advantage of it.
Oh, is that a spy? Oh, he's changed. It was just for the spawn. Damn it. Looking forward to the first fire action cast of the day. As we see TCM just moving forward, trying to cap the point. The bomb comes out to try and get on, and actually really nice work. AMS gets onto Statler. That's going to take the wind out of their sails, and if they can get forward enough, Hakuna should be able to deny the point, but he's just spamming pipes, not being any pressure onto that point, and TCM is going to be able to walk forward unopposed. Flushy with that 100% Uber, they should just be able to walk into last. I say should, they've already messed up one, I think, straight Uber push, which was the last one. That time they had Crits though to come out, and Ramagan is still a fair way off. They're pushing really nice pressure onto Settler though, but he's taking too long to go down, and the Heavy has come out now, and he's just still on that point, completely dominating. Empty picks up the frag on Sheepy, Captain goes down to AMS, and it's going to be another hold.
Settler is on Spy, the Demoman for TCM has off-classed the Spy. This is unconventional, to say the least. He's decloaking, he's coming up behind. Oh, he's been spotted. What is he doing? Obviously, if he got the medic, he would have been a genius, but now he's completely... Well, that's demo down, essentially, for the next push. And they've got crits advantage, and how are you going to hold against a team pushing with crits if you don't have a demo man?
Yeah, exactly. Especially... You need that sticky trap or the really close soldier bomb to deny the... To deny the ability to get out into the open and shoot shoot long range. I'm looking to see where Flush's positioning is. He's just reachable. Will he get out in time? The sticky falls short though from Kuna. Doesn't have the distance. He might just catch off that soldier. Really nice sticky to catch off Kafka actually. They waited for 30 seconds or so before using that crits, but it paid off with that aim at the end. It now looks like they want to push back in Flushy. There's a soldier really close. They're gonna catch off the Uber. Big shot from Captain. Oh my god, Lippy was trying to get away, but Captain just jumped after him and took him down in the air while he was there himself. They're not going to be able to push much past this choke, but that was a nice Uber to retake middle.
Yeah, if it's possible for Ryan to change up crits, he really needs to do it now because TCM are overreacting perfectly to it. Kuna has no one to shoot at, and by the time he's got someone to shoot at, TCM have Uber. Or so he either has a bad crit or it's crits versus Uber. And it looks like Coast to Coast are going to push early, which is a good sign. It means they're going to have time to get in position before they have the crits. But look, TCM have just backed out. The control
point is being captured. Yeah, they really gave it to him then. And you can't blame him in the sense that they don't want to take a fight when they could instantly be crits on and they're not close there themselves. But they're still 80% away and they could get them here with the crits. Crits can, once again fall short and the pressure is instantly on. Settler takes down Ramagan. There's going to be no more crits there. And they get Kuna as well. They lose Settler, but in that trade, that's pretty good for them. There's a fight going on at the moment. Both Coast to Coast scouts trying to put the pressure on the scouts from TCM, but with an Uber to back them up, both scouts from Coast to Coast are going to go down, and that's ultimately going to be a pretty good trade. I mean, they didn't need to use the Uber there, but it gave them the players such in the follow-up fight now, and they might actually be able to push on to second because of that. Because they kept their scouts alive, that is.
Yeah, it looks like this is going to be another... Oh, it's definitely going to be another second. I have a feeling that TCM is going to take this last one. And Ramagan goes down really well played by Happy Cool. He ran down through about four people to get the medic before he got taken down himself. And this definitely should be a last push. As soon as TCM get the Uber, it should be a successful last push.
Yeah, I mean, in the last couple of last pushes, they've Ubered in uncontested, but the crits has come out maybe 10 seconds later into each of the pushes. The Heavy has also worked really well from Coast to Coast. I'm surprised they're not seeing that. But I think now with Uber advantage on, TCM is definitely the time to be running Pyro, would you agree?
Yeah, and it's Talash has just read your mind and he's changed. The problem is, TCM play well against the Pyro. They don't send everyone through at the exact same time, so there's like leeway to kill him.
The pop though, Captain was checking to see if there's a Pyro there and Cool not to pop, but Flushy popped anyway, and this is a complete fair Uber.
Wow.
Flushy could even get caught out here. That soldier goes in at the end and he's going to get caught out. Nice pipe from Kuna. Kafka can't escape, and that's completely failed Uber. They got no frags at all.
That caster's curse. TCM have been playing really well against the Pyro, and then as soon as I say that, they run straight into a Pyro and get stuck, and the Pyro does more damage to them than they do to the Pyro.
And Captain calling out himself as well. Ramagan just about going to hit 100%. Is this Uber or is this crit? It is Uber for once, and they managed to get forward. AMS takes down Flushy, really well played from him. That was just exactly what they could have wanted from an Uber. Having taken crit so long, it's really impressive that they switched with such efficiency. But in the after fight, they're not doing so well. Happy Cool has taken down, has got so many frags here, and it's just Settler left alive against Palash and hits a really nice pipe. Soldiers coming bombing him now. Settler might just be able to escape, but it looks like they want to flank him at the moment. I'm looking at Empty, who's getting all the way around onto middle. Where is Settler, though?
I think he might be hiding in Cave. I don't know where he's gone.
He's giving him the juice,
it's too,
for sure.
Too late to get him now. If he stays in, he's going to die. That was well played by TCM, and they lost their medic, and they realised that they weren't in a great position, and they didn't have brilliant health. So they just sacked everyone in and got down Ramagan and made it a fair, well, made it a messy fight, which was a fair fight, and they came out the better from it.
Yeah, and now the Ubers are probably, for the first time in ages, actually more or less equal. Previously, we've seen either team pushing with an advantage constantly. We might actually see our first sort of choke point stalemate for a while.
Yeah, we've not actually seen this one before. And we've not really had very many Uber versus Uber situations, not since the first mid. And it looks like Coast want to push this, actually, and they've got a pick.
They definitely need to push, actually, because there's 7 minutes left and they do still need 3 rounds to equalise it. They managed to get Settler with their Uber, but they don't manage to get Flushing. He's still going to have his Uber. Are they going to push back in for middle, though? It doesn't look like they are, actually. Then they don't want to contest this middle. They just want to save their Uber for second, I guess. Flushing needs to get forward now to save both soldiers. Quite a hard job. He lets one die, manages to catch the other, though, but they pick up enough frags. That's three down at the moment, and Ramagan really needs to get out of here. His players are still trying to fight, though. They should just be running back, though. Palace eventually gets the calls, and they're going to escape, hopefully. Palace really needs to not turn around and fight at the moment. He got down to 60 HP there, just so tempted by the chance to turn around and duel the scout. But Ramagan will survive, and they should have this uber advantage for second.
Yeah, it was a good idea from Coast to Coast. It's just poor execution. They lost a few key players who strayed a bit too far out. And once they got the force out, it was good, but they were so far out that they couldn't escape the Uber, and TCM reclaimed the mid. But now Coast to Coast have a decent chance to push, and they've already started pushing through. Kuna's in a really good position to keep the enemy team out, and it doesn't look like they're gonna get forced. But now TCM have the Uber, so Coast to Coast wanna force this on them.
Yeah, and they do actually get the force out. I think this is going to be a much better Arthur Uber for Coast to Coast. They're just completely stuck, and they dropped someone else. Oh, that was really unlucky by Flushy there. He was caught behind a corner and couldn't get a flash onto Captain, and now they really need to run. Ubers are equal, but they need to keep every player alive they can. Flushy going down. Really good chase there from Coast to Coast. They get Sheepy as well. Once they've capped second, they've got five players there to push onto last. This should be an easy last cap. Just Kafka left alive. And we're going to see 3-1. Oh, big juggle there. Xamster tried to jump onto point, but got juggled away. And Empty's going to cap it out, and we're going to have 3-1. Comeback is still possible.
Comeback is real. My prediction is real. Now Coast to Coast are on Uber, I believe in my prediction. I'm not really sure what that whole 10 minutes of crits, or however long it was about.
Just testing the water.
Yeah. Changing the meta, you know.
False sense of security. I thought Xamster was so close to doing the fast roller then, but he just didn't hit the skip rocket in storeroom. Instead, opting to play it more slowly. It's a relatively early bomb coming in from Liffy, but he gets shot down halfway and decides that instead of it. Now we see the double soldier bomb coming, but they're just doing such a good job of denial here. That must have been, it was an air shot from AMS to deny. But they're going to be forced all the way back here, Coast to Coast, coming all the way back. And TCM is just going to flood over a point. They've picked up so many frags as well. They need to run here. Ramagan on 90%, but they look like they definitely want to chase here. Hafikul takes down Kuna. It's just, he goes for the Uber Saw. He gets the Uber. Nice play from Ramagan there, but we're still going to have 100% from Flushy pushing on to last.
Yeah. Coast to Coast need to do something here. I mean, if TCM just decide to play this one slowly, it could be really, really bad for Coast to Coast.
Run the clock down.
Yeah, I mean, they're 2 rounds down, and, well, they actually, AMS gets the force
nice
out, so
force.
TCM are forced to do something here. And they're coming in through the same door.
They get Settler, who goes in too far alone, and Sheepy goes in alone, and Hathikul, they're all going in alone. And really nice defense from Coast to Coast. It was a big force by AMS to get it out in the first place, but they didn't lose it at all, Flushy. Flushy took out Uber through one single door. Kafka will take down Kalash, but...
It's going to last, actually. It's going to be a 1v1 and last. Oh, no, it's 2v1.
2v1, yeah. Kafka is caught against two soldiers, which he's good, but he's not that good. And we're going to see the fairly slim advantage, actually, for Ramagan as they try and push onto middle.
They do have the player advantage, so I want to see them push fast and just try and take the mid for free, because they don't have that. Well, Captain could bomb, but they don't have the Roma, who's definitely going to be the one to sack. But they're taking their time.
Yeah, not forcing early. That's a really nice job by them not to have to force. They really should try and get some aggression onto them though, TCM. They've basically given up this mid for free. The Soldier comes bombing through. They managed to pick up Kuna there. That was a nice job by Kafka. As the Uber comes through and they haven't lost anyone yet. A really nice play from TCM. The Uber finally comes out, but they've only got a scout left to fight with. They do take down Captain, but in the general scheme of things, this has been much better for TCM. As now they can come back in once Coast to Coast's Uber is worn out. Ramagan is quite weak. Liffy is weak. He's going to go down. It's just Scout and Medic left alive for Coast to Coast at the moment. Where is Ramagan though? Is he out?
He's on mid, he's coming back. He was running away, but he saw the fight was turning towards his team. And actually, it looks like TCM are going to try and contest this. And wow, MG nice gets rocket. Destroyed by Sansa.
Yeah, nice play then. Oh, but the big shots from Sheiky there. It didn't do, I'm not sure which scout that was, but just didn't do a good enough job of defending his medic. But I think, I'm going to give that to Sheepy, actually. That was some really nice shots he hit. As we see Lippy hiding now, ready to jump around the corner as Flushy pushes. He needs to push Storm for this strategy to work, though. But he's pushed choke, he needs to be seen. Flushy should dodge this, but a really nice play from Lippy, actually. Gets the force out really early. And this will be equal Uber versus equal Uber. Settler just jumps into Kuna's stickies. Did you see that?
Yeah. not the best play from Settler, but Coast to Coast are definitely forced to do something now, and Settler dying there has given them the perfect opportunity. There's only 2 minutes on the clock to get two rounds. It's possible, but they need to move fast.
And yeah, the big jump comes out. Kuna trying to get forward into that point. He gets one shot on the scout, but retreating away. They managed to keep everyone alive here, TCM. But the Uber's still in favor of Coast to Coast. They really need to push out here. 2 minutes left, they need to get two rounds. These need to be quick.
Yeah, they're pushing in early. They're doing exactly what they're supposed to do. So watch out for these stickies. Settler just backs out. He's done no damage to him, which is really good for Coast to Coast, and they've still got a tiny advantage.
Could get caught out here as well, Settler. He's being juggled in. It's Kuna versus Settler. If either of them hits a pipe, the other will go down. But Kuna calls Talash, and Talash does the cleanup. AMS goes down on the other side of the map, but Roaming Soldier for Demoman is definitely going to be a pet trade here for Coast to Coast. They're carrying on through choke here, but they need the rest of their team to back them up before they do, and they're going to get forced. Captain is still quite close down, but he gets Talash isn't Ubered. Talash is going to be furious about that. He would have got the kill on Captain. Flush wasn't going to save him in time, but Captain hits a nice sweet rocket just as Talash's Uber wears off. And this is going to be a much better situation for TCM in terms of players. They've got the Uber advantage Coast to Coast, but they really don't have the players.
Yeah.
And
coast really right now, need they, to push now. They need to push. The time.
1 minute
if,
10.
If they don't push in the next couple of seconds, they've lost the game.
Yeah, I can't.
They're taking their sweet time. Okay, the soldier bombs in, they're getting space, but it looks like it's going to be over.
They really can't back off at all. I mean, if they caught around in 20 seconds, I still don't think it's possible to get one in 35, so this might be a close end to the map, but I think ultimately we're calling it a GG to TCM. They're still not going to stop Coast to Coast coming forward, though. They've got, it's just the straight deathmatch fight with Lippy left alive. He's jumping around on point, trying to get something done, but he's going to get focused down by the scout. Surely, Happy Cool cleans up the final frag. Nice work from Settler to catch a couple there, couple of frags there with the pipes. And Sheepy and Happy Cool getting frags too. But ultimately, we are going to see this map go in favor of TCM against both of our predictions.
I am. I'm impressed by how TCM were playing that game. Especially with their demo for Spy classic play. Worked out really well. I'm not really sure what that was about.
Yeah, the GG coming out from, GG coming out from Kuna. We've got only 5 seconds left, and we will go on to see TCM playing against MainCore.tf in the final of the Logjam Cup. Still probably going to be one-sided, but TCM have shown a strong performance, winning both of the maps we've casted of them tonight. MainCore, though, I think they've pretty much won 5-0 by win difference pretty quickly in their games, so...
If I was TCM and I was going up against MainCore, I wouldn't go to mid, because I reckon they're going to get stomped on these mid fights. Because Warhai, yeah, is like Settler's good, but he's obviously not as good as a top prem demo. And sure. I think Warhai, yeah, is just going to stomp on him on mid.
Yep. I'm going to see if we're going to get any logs coming through right now. Refreshing logs.tf to my heart out. But nothing coming through yet. I'm not sure if they're logs or not or anything, but either way, hoping we'll see the final coming along soonish. I know MainCore have been waiting quite a while by the time, to the extent that Ips was sort of coming into chat about 5 minutes into the game we just did. It's the logs are out.
Yeah, look, the damage says it all. I mean, the top, what is it? The top six players, five of them are TCM players, with Kuna making second place on the damage. Captain looked like he came out on top in terms of the pocket fight with the big 9k damage to AMS's 6.5k. So that's well played, Captain, although he did take quite a lot more heals. I mean, look at how many heals Flushy got out compared to Ramagan. I mean, the deaths, Flushy died 6 times, Ramagan died 16 times.
That is pretty bad. I guess it's to the extent that Ramagan went crit so often that when they made the crits plays, he'd often go down anyway. Yeah. So they went. Look at that, 10 crit screes though.
Yeah, I mean,
but 21 Uber charges is a massive amount for a single map though.
Yeah,
that's
imagine
incredible.
What it would have been like if Coast to Coast had Uber charged the whole map. It would have been a different story, I feel, because their crit screens, they just weren't working out. I think the only successful crit screen they had was the one defending last.
Sure. But yeah, I mean, the 12k heals for Captain surely stands out. I mean, compared to the other side, which were fairly spread, despite Flushy getting quite substantially more heals now than Ramagan. Partly, I guess you can attribute due to deaths and things, but yeah, a massive amount of heals going out for Captain, which who did really well actually. He didn't, as with a pocket who's getting that many heals, you'd assume he'd taking a lot more damage, but looking at him only catching 7k damage is fairly low actually.
And look at Sheepy getting 6.7k heals, sorry. That's the most amount of heals I think I've ever seen on a scout.
Although I think a lot of it is building.
Yeah, but still I've never really seen heals go that high for a scout.
Sure.
But then obviously it paid off because he did very well in terms of logs. I mean, he went 33 for 10.
Mm. Oh, I think we're hopefully we're gonna be quicker on the server side of things than we were last time. Hopefully we've got the server coming up pretty instantaneously. Last time, of course, the issue was with TCM, so hopefully we won't get the same kind of thing again. Might be on the same server, I guess. I think Ari's just posted it, so yeah, I think it was the same one as last time, Stuck.
Okay. Maybe I can get my plugin working this time. Definitely. So I can actually see who people are.
I suggest you keep talking for a bit. I just need to edit something to my power charger.
Okay.